800 million people living in the ruin of the old world. Only one thing fighting for order in the chaos. The men and women of the Hall of Justice.
You know, when I was about 17, I was working in a pizza joint in Wellington, New Zealand, and the manager of that was a big Judge Dredd fan, and he kind of turned me on to it. I was reading it for years. So when the opportunity arose to become part of this, you know, I had very strong views about how it should be done and how it shouldn't be done. I met with the writers. I went with the writer Alex Garland and director Pete Travis and Andrew and Alon, and they said, look, you do realize that Dredd keeps his helmet on the entire film. And I said, I wouldn't be having this meeting if he didn't. So, you know, we were all on the same page right from the get-go. You know, as a long-term fan of the comic, I wanted it to be recognizably Dredd. And if you've ever read a Judge Dredd comic, then, you know, that that scowl, that perpetual scowl that is on his face never really leaves. So, you know, this is my interpretation of what that would be. It's certainly a challenge, you know. The eyes are a huge tool for an actor, and to take those away, then you have to start to think about what else you have available to help tell the story. And so, you know, elements like the voice becomes very important, you know, your body language, how you move, and it really is amazing how much comes through without the eyes. In the comics, the voice was described as a saw cutting through bone. So the voice is kind of my interpretation of what that is.
Well, you got one now.
And now, you know, we're at the point where, you know, it's not my film anymore. I'm handing it over to an audience. It's your film. It's your film. And that's cool too. That's it's like, you know, sort of nurtured this little baby along for a couple of years, and now this little birdie's flying.